The modern world is home to many chemicals, airborne substances, drugs, and plants that can be extremely poisonous to your pets when inhaled, ingested, or even just upon contact with its skin. I am a veterinarian from South Africa, and in this video, I'm going to give you a quick crash course on what common household products are poisonous to your dog, what signs to watch out for when your dog is poisoned, and which immediate care and prevention methods you need to apply in order to potentially save his life. And we're starting right now. Now, some poisons, such as chemicals, paint, or tar on the skin, is much more obvious than others, such as ingested plant material, drugs, chemicals, or even inhaled substances. Dogs are very inquisitive animals and will put almost anything inside their mouths. Unfortunately, this does mean that they are much more prone to swallowing all sorts of poisonous material, most of the time by accident, with some causing unpleasant side effects, whilst others can often be fatal without treatment. If your dog possibly ingested any acids, alkalis, petroleum products, household chemicals, non-prescribed drugs, or toxic plants, and he's showing any of these clinical signs displayed on the screen, your dog might have been poisoned, and you should immediately be concerned. Now, first things first, don't panic. Immediately remove your dog from the source of poison using safety equipment such as gloves, masks, and goggles. If your dog is seizuring, move it to a safer area away from sharp objects where he won't be able to hurt himself. If possible, try and identify the toxin. And if your dog has vomited, collect a small sample of it in a plastic bag and save it for your veterinarian. It will be extremely useful for him or her to make a diagnosis later on. Never ever induce vomiting without consulting your veterinarian first, as you may aggravate the problem by causing another chemical reaction, or your dog might aspirate some of the vomit into its lungs, which will lead to a severe pneumonia. Instead, flush out your dog's mouth with lukewarm water using a showerhead without pointing the hose directly to the back of its mouth. Contact your veterinarian and let him know that you are on your way. This will allow him to prepare for your arrival so that your dog can be attended to immediately. You might need to induce vomiting, administer activated charcoal, or pump your dog's stomach in order to try and remove some of the toxins. Toxic fumes may come from substances such as household chemicals, insecticides, tear gas, and smoke from fires. These types of fumes irritate and inflame a dog's airway, making it difficult to breathe, as well as causing some other symptoms displayed on the screen. It is critical that you act quickly when your dog is exposed to toxic fumes. Do not underestimate the amount of damage that inhaled smoke or airborne toxins can inflict, as inflamed airways can cause a dog to die of asphyxiation within hours. Move your dog away to an area away from the toxic fumes without endangering yourself. Try and keep your dog's air passages open and maintain its breathing. Flush out your dog's eyes with fresh water or a dog-specific eye wash. Take the dog to the vet immediately. All sorts of chemicals, from tar and paint remover to gasoline and an overdose of tick and flea medication, can cause skin irritation and burns when they contact the dog's skin. They can even affect the dog's mouth when he licks the substance. Poisons on the skin are usually the result of accidents, such as the dog bumping into a container or being too close to a work area. Any substance coating your dog's fur must be quickly identified, either by means of sight or smell. Wear rubber gloves to protect your hands. Rub large amounts of mineral or vegetable oil into the contaminated area to try and loosen the substance. If the area is heavily contaminated, you can mix flour or powdered starch into the oil to help absorb some of the poison. If the substance has already hardened, it is better to cut away the fur. Once the substance is loosened, use warm, soapy water to bathe the area. Baby shampoo and dishwashing liquid is ideal, as it is gentle and will not cause further irritation to the dog's skin. Rinse the area thoroughly and repeat the process until the contaminant is completely removed. Never use other chemicals to remove the substance, such as paint thinners, turpentine, and mineral spirits. Check the skin and especially inside the mouth for burns. These may take hours to appear and will often only show up in the esophagus or the stomach. Some burns can be quite severe and will require immediate veterinary attention. The best treatment for poison is prevention. Always treat your dog the same way that you would treat a young, inquisitive child. Keep your dog away from work areas to prevent them from playing where contaminants are used. Ensure that all chemicals are safely contained and stored out of reach of inquisitive paws and noses. If you use rodenticides or insecticides, such as tick or flea shampoos, make sure to read the instructions and follow the dosages carefully. Keep human medication in a safe and secure location. Avoid self-administration of over-the-counter medication without consulting your veterinarian first. When giving prescribed medication, make sure to read the label carefully in order to make sure that you're giving the right drug and dosage to your pet. Do not keep poisonous plants in or around your house. When building a fire, be aware of the materials being used and keep dogs out of enclosed areas that may fill up with smoke. Thank you for watching this video. If you found the content to be useful, make sure to give the video a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, and hit that notification button, as I'll be posting new videos on interesting pet-related topics every week. As always, have a lucky day, and I'll see you in another video next week. Cheers!